Hi, I'm Dino Bassanese, Chief Product Manager from Click4Time online scheduling software. Welcome to our quick setup guide video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Facebook. You may be a bit overwhelmed by the number of settings and options that are in the system. Don't let it deter you. It's possible that many of the settings don't even apply to your business. Most have been defaulted to options that benefit the majority of the types of businesses that use our software to manage tens of thousands of appointments per month. It's important for me to mention that businesses that take the time to complete these basic setup tasks have much greater success in increasing their efficiency and consistently booking more appointments. The purpose of this video is to walk you through the most important settings and features you may want to consider reviewing in order to ensure your business is ready to take online bookings from clients. Even if you intend to use the calendar internally at first and not allow clients to book online, these settings are still important to review. Now keep in mind, this is a brief setup guide and only scratches the surface of what Click4Time can do for you and your business. We do have a library of other training videos that cover the system in much greater detail. Be sure to look for the links to these videos throughout the system and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all the latest updates. Starting in the Settings, Configuration, Basic tab, the first thing, of course, would be to complete your business details, including address, business phone number, and email address. Now, there's a special consideration about the email address, though. The email listed in this page will be used by Click4Time to keep you up to date with system improvement notices and advisories. As well, it will be displayed in invoices or receipts, and client appointment notifications will appear to be sent from this address. If there's a different email address you would like clients to reply to for your notifications, you may set that up under Notifications, Client Notifications, the Email Address Reply To field. Next section is your business logo. Your brand is important, and displaying your business logo to your clients on the booking pages, appointment notifications, and invoices or receipts should be done early on. You definitely want to make sure your clients recognize that they are in the right place, and your logo will do just that. So just browse for the image in your files, upload it, drag the handles to crop the image as needed, and save the thumbnail. Now, the image must be a JPEG, a GIF, or PNG that's no larger than 5 megabytes and must not have a transparent background, as those will not display properly. Continuing with the look of the client-side calendar, in the Advanced Settings, Client Calendar View section, the color of the client calendar background can be set to match your brand or business website. Select the color picker to find the matching color using the color sliders or the advanced color picker. When you have the color you want, choose the select button and remember to apply your changes. You can always confirm these changes by going to the top of the screen and selecting the Client View to see what your clients see. And to get back to your business settings, any of the dashboard links here will get you there. Now, your business may have a cancellation policy, or you're so busy that you need to cap how far clients can book into the future. These settings are adjusted in the Advanced Settings, Client Booking Limits section. Now, forcing your clients to register for an account may be a good idea. The benefit is that your clients who book online will have access to manage their own appointments anytime, anywhere. This can save you and your staff a lot of time. There is another consideration, though, if making sign-up mandatory. Some clients are not comfortable or willing to register for online accounts, even though they will be providing the same information, no more or no less, to complete the booking. So just be aware of any trends that point to clients being deterred from online booking if this is set to yes. It may just be a matter of educating your clients of the benefits of online booking. Now, one of the major features of Click4Time is the invoicing and reporting system. I can't count how many businesses start using the system, thinking they won't use these included robust features, and later on realize what they're missing, but now can't generate accurate financial data. It's well worth a few seconds to set up your currency in finance configuration to start. Another important consideration from the get-go is taxes. If your services are taxable, whether those taxes are included in your fees or added on, setting this up now will keep all the invoices and related financial reports in check for later use. You'll find these options in Finance, Settings, Define Taxes, and Assign Taxes. Check out our video on managing finances to learn more about setting up and assigning taxes. In the Setup Wizard, just after signing up, you created your first service. To keep it simple though, we left out several of the service-related settings. So to add to your list of services or edit an existing service, you're going to want to go to Settings, Services. For example, your services may be taxable, so you'll need to edit that first service to add the tax and set whether it's included in the fee or not. Remember, I mentioned needing to set up your taxes early on. Well, if you haven't completed that yet, you'll need to do it now, if it applies to your business. You may also want to automatically include time between appointments by setting a cleanup time. You'll find that in the duration and assignment section. Do take the time to fill in the service description section as well. This information is made public to search engines to help your services get found through online searches. For more detailed information about services, check out our video on creating and managing services. Now, you may have staff or resources that are assigned to perform services for clients. After creating all your services, you'll want to go to Settings, Service Providers, to add your staff, assign the services they perform, and set up their schedules of availability. If your services require a piece of equipment or a machine to be scheduled instead of a person, we consider these standalone resources. You can set these up in Settings, Resources, Schedules, Standalone Resources. You can find a link to the relevant training videos in both the Service Providers and Resources tabs. Now, it may be important for your business to collect certain information from clients when they book or when being added to your client database. Settings, Booking Fields is where you can choose which information is optional or required. There are two sets of checkboxes. The first is relevant to the client-side bookings, where your clients will be completing the selected fields. The other is to set the company view booking fields, the information you or your staff will be collecting when adding a client to your database. One of the major benefits of online booking is the automatic notifications to your clients. Probably the most important of all are the appointment reminders, which can help to reduce no-shows by up to 80%. Reminders are controlled in Settings, Notifications, Client Notifications. You can set up to 3 reminders to be sent at different times ahead of the booking. Oh, and here's a little bonus tip. You can modify the email template wording in Email Templates. Now that you've set up all the essentials, you should be just about ready to let the world know your online booking calendar is open for business 24/7. How do you do that? Well, if you already have a business website, you'll need to add a Book Now button to any page that you feel needs a call to action. The Marketing Web Integrations tab contains the code you need to display a button of your choice on your site. You can choose a size, color, and style for the button. Then copy the related code to be pasted into your website. Now, if all this makes your head spin, it may be best to ask the 10-year-old down the street for help. Just kidding. It's not a difficult task, but you may need help from someone who has some experience in managing websites if you're not sure how to do this. Now, if you prefer to display a compact calendar within a page on your website, you can choose the embedded calendar code to copy and paste into your site. You can even add a Book Now button to your Facebook page. Now, if you don't have a business website yet, not to worry. The booking calendar is your website. That's why it's important to add your business details, logo, and set a calendar color. Existing and potential clients will be able to find your booking website in two ways. You advertise your website calendar URL, or web address, through an email blast or whatever other marketing methods you prefer. The booking URL tab will display the address you should promote. Or someone may be searching for the types of services you provide and come across that carefully crafted service description you added. Told you it was important, which would link to your booking calendar. Adding service descriptions, a Book Now button, or embedded calendar is critical to your success in booking more appointments. Clients can't book if they can't find you online. Now, why start from scratch if you don't have to? If you already have a list of clients, including details like name, email address, birth date, and notes, you can send that to us at support@click4time.com, and we will import it for you. This is super helpful if you already have a large list of clients you're migrating from another system. You definitely don't want to add those one at a time. Your list should be in Excel or a CSV format for us to import. And finally, your internal company calendar. This is where you and your staff will book and manage appointments. Booking an appointment is as easy as moving to the appropriate date in the calendar and selecting the time to add the booking. Fill in the required details. And voila, you've booked an appointment. To view the details of an appointment, simply select the appointment to open the edit screen. Here you can do things like change the date and time, the service, or service provider. You can view and edit client information. You can apply adjustments and payments to invoices. View the client's appointment history and the appointment audit trail. The company calendar is stacked with powerful time-saving features, and it's definitely worthwhile to check out our training video on managing the company calendar. Of course, you can find that in our YouTube channel. If you're serious about getting the most out of Click4Time, these are the bare essentials for a successful setup. I would suggest taking the time to watch all the training videos. The system is a powerful business-building tool if you use it to its potential. If there's something we didn't cover in our videos, maybe you'll find the answers in our extensive FAQs found in the Help tab. You'll also find our phone number and support ticket system if you have more specific questions or a scenario that hasn't been addressed. Well, that covers it for the quick setup. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all the latest updates. You can also check us out on Facebook and Twitter. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We look forward to helping you grow your business. This is Dino Bassanese, Chief Product Manager for Click4Time Online Scheduling Software.